Welcome to Outtakes No Balls, the video from Borough TV with myself, Alistair Brownlee, and as always on the Red Settee, the Borough living legend, Bernie Slavin. What?
Before we go.
We haven't started the video yet.
This video's just arrived.
And right. I don't think you're going to be too happy. Personally, I think it does you justice. But I think you'll be seeing yourself. I said, look at that. Can the camera catch that?
Hang on a second. Is that the cover?
That's a cover. You're going to be frightening a few kids come Christmas.
No, well, if that's going to be the cover, there's no way that I'm taking part in this video because it's absolutely disgraceful.
I think it does you justice.
I mean, one of them might
I'm
even
sure
buy that one.
It. What do you think?
No.
I think it does you justice, that. Have you got a solicitor?
Yeah, well, I think we'll get the solicitor to ring me a little bit later on. With regard to Borough TV, we started off in February, yeah?
We did.
Yeah, and like any professional football club, from time to time, things have gone a little bit haywire. What are your memories of the year? You had some fun work alongside me, living legend.
I enjoyed working with you. I enjoyed all the cock-ups, part of the job. But yeah, I enjoyed it. I enjoyed it.
You're looking a bit scruffier than you do normally.
I'm just trying to match yourself.
I think it's outrageous. We're only a few seconds into the making of this video. Not only have I been insulted on the front cover, but Bernie Slavin has come along here in a very scruffy manner indeed. But there's an old saying, he who laughs last, laughs longest. And Bernie Slavin's been doing some laughing this year.
Talking right up here. Can I talk and walk? Of course I can.
You sure?
Yeah, of course. Right. I could run around the block and talk.
Okay.
Right, I done. Right. Thanks to Paul Merson. Next week in Bernie's About, we'll be travelling to Old Trafford to talk to my old mate Gary Pallister. So we'll see you next week. That's just the car gets me. I'm saying it, I'm going to say it. Yeah, I'll see it, right. Have you seen them behind you?
Right.
He's looking at me with that smile. Okay. Sorry, right, go on, Al. Right. Don't smile at me. You make me laugh.
How dare you have a good time?
Okay.
All right, go for it.
Hold on.
Are you
right? Right, we're on.
Laughing at me.
This is like Cheshire Cat. Right, okay, you go on then, right, go on.
Hang on, is this going?
Right, we can do it. Go on, Al.
It's like one of those Peter Sellers movies.
Right, okay. We're on.
No.
Oh, come on, we need to have done it, yeah.
Go.
And the question...
He hasn't even done his face.
All right, okay. Hang on. We've got too much time to
do. Come on, we've done it. I'm serious, dude. Come on.
But don't look at this. Right. Okay. And the question, Bernie, is?
Yeah, the question is, who scored...
No! That was last week's question.
Steady on. Let's take a minute. Right, take a minute. Just to compose yourself, man, for God's sake.
Right, a packed mailbag. As always on Borough TV. Come on, draw the winner out for the signed shirts. Right, go on then. Well, you can't you read or something? I love it when it comes up. Come on then.
Yeah, the winner this week.
Is? I do love this. I do love this.
It's so ridiculous, isn't it? He's got out of me.
Welcome, Vix.
He's laughing.
What?
Yeah, I'm letting he's gone.
Right.
Right, okay then, right. Welcome back to Borough TV.
No use looking down.
Space throw ever.
That was the best. That was the best throw ever. Right, this time.
Do you like that?
Yeah.
Really?
That was quality.
That's how we get bit.
Okay, go. Hey, I swear to God, Dan, I was going like that. I'm sorry.
Hear
that?
I've heard rumours when taking penalty kicks, you used to run from the halfway line. Is that true, or is that just a load of tosh?
A load of tosh.
Load of tosh.
Do
you want me to do it again?
Yeah.
Yeah. Hold on. I've heard the rumour that when taking penalty kicks, you used to take a run from the halfway line. Is that true? Right, okay.
Oh,
that's a lot of
We come back, we did, honestly, we come back, and of course, we got back in the afternoon, and it was Stephen Pearce's testimonial that night.
Oh, yeah.
I couldn't move. I'm telling you, I couldn't move an inch. I mean,
half the team couldn't move that night.
Half the team couldn't move. I mean, all the crowd were looking at me going out. I mean, my backside was just red rot. Indeed, I mean, Dr. Dunn, the club doctor, he went bananas, he did.
He's got a fair bum.
He went bananas. and they put us on steroids, he did. Yeah. So thanks for the steroids.
Only you miss it, that connection, man, with Susanna. Forget that in a minute. Do you get a bit of serious about him?
There you go, knocking on. That's a good one.
Right, we're going to ask you about when the phone was arrived, right?
Yeah.
Oh, dear God. Right.
Yeah.
Hold on, what are you drinking? Dear God, man, Hendo. This is meant to be work. Right. He's like,
he's got a fair bum.
This is going to be the Christmas episode.
Oh, dear.
Now, come on, what was all this about with Dr. Dunn?
You have to laugh. Have you seen the size of Dr. Dunn's bum? Dr. Bum's done. Anyway, he's got nearly as big a bum as you have.
This is all about outtakes. We had more in the opening exchange of this video. Yeah. John Henry seemed to enjoy that.
Yeah,
I mean, there was
tears. The tears were rolling down his face. I was laughing. The camera crew was laughing. It was a great day. You know, it was that was the best interview so far.
Yeah, it was actually a genuine one. There's no way you could set anything.
No. I'm just off the cuff, and you know, it all stemmed from Dr. Dunn's bum.
Now, we've had Bernie Slavin having the giggle so far, but occasionally the players and the fans have caused moments of humour.
Oh, they have, yeah.
And I remember for one occasion popping out to do a Vox with all the supporters around the area just before the trip to Wembley and asking all sorts of questions about whether you'd rather go to Florida or Wembley. And that seemed to pose one or two problems. I mean, you'd rather go to Wembley because you wouldn't fly to Florida.
Definitely, I'd go to Wembley.
But sometimes, even the simplest of things can cause the biggest problems. Now, would you believe this is the address board for Totally Red on Borough TV? But you ask a footballer to read it, and all sorts of problems ensue.
Wherever you are. Borough TV at Comcast Teesside, Robert's house.
Gives a clue, man.
De Havilland Avenue.
De Havilland Avenue. Yeah, okay.
Okay.
All right.
Here we go.
I'll wait until everyone gets out the road.
De Havilland.
De Havilland Avenue, Preston Farm Business Park, Stockton, TS18, 3T.
You've got to get somebody sensible to do something like that.
It'll take me 20 goes, are you?
No, you're doing all right. Go on.
Borough TV, at Comcast Teesside. Take three.
Right, whatever you want.
Is there enough lights?
Yeah, I've got it, don't worry.
Cheers. Wait until this figure gets out of there.
Shut up, you fucking damn
Well, I'm talking.
Can you believe that? That's our doctor as well.
Jesus.
God help us all. No wonder everyone's sick. These germs are flying about.
Borough TV, a Comcast Teesside, Robert House, De Havilland Avenue, Preston Farm Business Park, Stockton, TS18. 3TH. Email Borough TV
What is that? You've got to wait a lot of time to see Middlesbrough get to Wembley, but now you've got your tickets, it's got to be all worthwhile, hasn't it?
Ah, yeah, certainly do, mate, but are you going to do the same performance as you do, beat them at 3-1?
We'll see you at Wembley. Tell them.
See you at Wembley, right?
Yeah.
Talk to me about the tie.
I have to change myself.
The tie? Nice?
The tie?
Honesty?
Look at that.
Honest?
Honest.
Yeah?
The worst tie that I've ever.
Any time now.
You can hit.
Very good player.
Excellent, excellent.
It's not mad, though. Here's your tenner.
Come on.
Get that camera off me.
Fuck you.
Leave, I'm not playing.
Watch that step.
Can't believe I'm not playing. It's a fucking bomb.
Oh, man, not playing. He's picking the wrong team.
Again.
Again.
What?
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 I should be playing right wing. Told you that.
You personally have gone from the verge of bankruptcy.
Me personally?
No, sorry.
No, it's all right.
For a TV, what we want to know is, if you had the chance to go to Florida or to go and see the Borough play at Wembley, which one would you take?
Florida.
Oh, cool. Everybody else has said Borough at Wembley.
Yeah, now they go to Florida.
Why is that? I mean, surely you'd rather watch your local team win the Cup of Wembley, wouldn't you?
I don't support the Borough.
Who would you support?
United.
Well, go to Florida then. Go to Florida. I hope you have a very nice time. Stay there. Can't find a Borough fan anywhere around here. So you're definitely not going to be tempted by this Florida trip?
No.
No?
No.
Wembley for you?
Yes.
OK. Give a quick good luck message for the Borough for Wembley.
Good luck, Berra.
OK.
Come on, quick.
Look, she's thrown away a holiday to Florida.
They wouldn't be coming because they're not mine.
We're just asking... So, we're just asking people today, who do you think that Brian Robson should sign for Middlesbrough in the summer to add to the squad for next season? Any ideas?
We've just met the only man in Middlesbrough who knows nothing about football.
Give us a footballer's name.
Can I think of one? Sorry.
Nothing at all. OK,
oh, God,
cheers.
Sorry.
I'm Nigel Pearson, you're watching Borough TV.
Can I have one
more? Can you take one with you?
All right, yep, no problem.
Put no, it. Don't,
like,
Carl,
just,
don't.
Just your rules, just... Just
no,
like
don't.
Yeah, all right, call me mouth open.
No. Pretend you're smelling it. Don't take any notice.
That's how it smells, I got in trouble.
Liv Anderson, 23, assistant manager, Middlesbrough Football Club. Thank you.
And three, two.
Brian Robson, manager of Middlesbrough Football Club, 21-year-old. If Anderson's 23, I'm 21.
Now, as it's well known around the studios here on Borough TV, I do enjoy the odd sandwich. And do you remember, Slav, when there was one occasion at the Sell at Riverside Stadium, I think you were trying to make me my supper, weren't you?
Was that the burger and the bun?
Yeah.
I never know how that bun beat the burger.
Let's get back to the memory again. So you actually put the burger in first,
yeah.
And yet the bun beat it through?
Yeah, I never know how that happened. Do you know the answer?
Well, I'm not too sure about that. Well, let's refresh our memory, shall we?
Go
let's
on.
Go back to it again. When Bernie tried to make me a burger at the Sell at Riverside Stadium.
Of course it is, yeah.
The food here is excellent.
Yeah, we spend a lot of time and effort trying to make it just right.
Now, can I give you a secret, Angie?
You can.
A member of your staff has failed to turn in tonight and we need some burgers. There's 30,000 people out there wanting a burger.
What are we going to do?
How about get a new recruit?
Bernie the Burger King. Have you got anybody in mind?
Bernie the Burger King. Should we give him a shout?
Yeah.
Slav!
Oh, yeah. Oh. I've even dressed for the occasion. How'd you like that?
All right. Angie.
Hello, Bernie.
Hiya, Darren.
How are you doing?
How are you? All right.
Instructions to this new starter.
Cool.
Right, I'll show you how to make a burger. Right, hands out your pockets
okay,
for
then,
a start.
Oh.
Right. Right, let it come over here. You play.
Come on, Sav,
I'll go around the way.
You've been eating enough burgers.
You can pick a burger up and you want right. Burgers.
Just with my hands.
Well, another pair of tongs, really.
Oh, we need tongs. Come on, hygiene.
I have green and white.
Celtic.
Up.
Republic.
We'll pretend you've got some tongs.
Oh,
okay.
We'll do a pretendy.
Hygiene with a hat on and an apron. Yeah. So
here we are, he's the tongs. Right. Don't start, Slav.
I used to be a guy in Glasgow tongs.
There's the jelly on the top of the machine.
There you go.
Pick a bun up.
Oh, that's an easy job, isn't it? This doesn't test you much, Mr. Slavin.
Tell you what, it's a hard work.
Separate it.
Separate it. Right. Well, I have to use my hands for that. Right.
Right. Put it on that side of the machine.
Yeah.
Right.
Is that it?
A bit later, it'll
Bernie,
come out the other end.
That doesn't look big enough for me.
Are you not kidding? That box isn't big enough for you, lad.
Where's this going to?
Get another bottle.
Where's this burger going?
Why, that was quick. That's one for last week. sorry.
This happens in all these good foods, you know, isn't it?
Right. Hold on. Hey, hold on, the game starts now.
It takes about a minute to come through.
A minute?
So what happens if you get... Oh, 2,000 people out there.
We put lots through together, we get ready, we prepare. Right.
They don't do one at a time, Sam. 66,000.
There's one now.
33 at a time.
30.
So they're coming out like a production line, like in a factory. They come out of the machine. You
Where's your burger,
up.
Penny?
Yeah, it's taking the same out.
It is. Has he got lost, Angie?
No, it's on his way, don't worry.
Do you have to shout it or something? Here, burger.
Come on, burger. Here, burger. We're very hungry. Do you have many people asking for jobs here, Angie?
Oh, lots and lots all the time. Yeah, we always need staff.
Yeah? So if anybody's watching Borough TV, fancy a job?
Oh, yes, certainly.
Yeah. You don't get burnt.
Hold it.
There you go, there's a bun coming out.
There's the bun. How come the bun beat the bug and the bugger's done first?
I don't know. Right. Yeah, I put that down. Right.
Anyway,
you like. Anyway, get the base. Right. Grab some mayonnaise. Pop a bit out.
With this?
Yep.
Of course.
All the way around. Right. That's it.
How are you dying for
You're
this?
You're not using your
fingers,
are you?
No, not at all. Hygiene.
Bernie's on fire.
Set a torch.
Get some lettuce.
Slam it on fire.
Dear God. It's not on fire, it's okay. Don't worry, it's not on fire.
Get a fire brigade.
Right, see you on top.
Right,
you ready for your
burger
from here?
Right, here we go.
Are you ready?
Where is it?
It's
smoky Joe's, isn't it? Are you sure it's going
on? It's on its way.
It's a barbecue.
It's a barbecue five-wheel burger.
You had some fire, lad. Here we go. Oh, God. Look at that.
Can you catch it, Ray?
Oh, I don't think this is alive.
You said fire.
You
said fire.
Hold on. Oh, sorry.
Hey, this is a comedy routine.
Wrap it up. Hold on. Oh. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much.
There you go. I know you want it. I know you want it. You keep that. Well done.
You got the job. Perfect.
Thank you very much.
No, that was fantastic. Lovely. Oh. Angie, thank you very much for letting us come in. In your kitchen. But,
I'm getting
yeah.
here.
You were sacked living. Outrageous. Good gear. It's not bad, actually.
It's not bad, even from a beginner.
Not bad.
Not bad.
Thanks, Angie.
Just like
now finish up now.
Cheers, yeah, thank
Thanks
you.
Thanks very much. Bernie.
Get away.
And we were only joking, Stanley, with regard to the burgers. And all the food that sell at Riverside Stadium is absolutely brilliant because Middlesbrough Football Club are not only the top 10, actually the best in the Premier League in terms of catering facilities. As you can see, it hasn't done me any harm whatsoever.
And he's not kidding.
Right, now, Bernie, one of the most questions that we receive on Borough TV is that you do a feature called Bernie's Abouts. And you do catch the mic from time to time, but do you catch it all the time?
Of course I do.
Right, I'm going to put a test for you now on this video.
Okay,
cue the mic. As I thought, Bernie Slaven doesn't catch the mic all
what
of the time.
What was that last one? Was that a cat?
Sit down.
Anyway, right, somebody's
tasked that. As I thought, Bernie Slaven doesn't catch the mic all of the time. Let's enjoy some of the outtakes.
Simon, I'm going to see you.
Hey, let's... You didn't put the end on.
You
didn't put the end on. My fault. I could snug and hear this coming.
Yeah.
It's coming now.
All right, action. Where's my brolly? Dear goodness. Dear, let's get something. Where's my mic?
It didn't have enough.
Jesus. Take two.
Hey, that was a throw, by the way.
Hey, that was a bad throw.
You go on then. This week in Bernie's about.
And wouldn't you believe the amount of damage the Bernie Slavin's caused to microphones around this place? As you saw in that feature there,
we did stop the. That,
what's this?
What's this?
We doing, sir?
£2,000 for damaging.
Come on,
microphones.
We're making a video. What's this?
£2,000 for damaging microphones over the season. They're joking.
Well, you better.
Are we insured?
Well, you better sign.
I hope you're insured. I ain't paying that. No way.
Well, I hope this video makes a few quid, because otherwise you're £2,000.
Just forget about that anyway. Here you go, mate.
Right.
I've been listening to you throughout the programme. You've been slotting the fans,
yep.
Having a go at the players, myself included. Who do you think you are? Peter Perfect?
Well, that's from
Peter. Well, let's have a look now at Brownlee's bloomers. And I don't mean his big pants.
That's good.
What's she talking about?
This is the media room, Alistair, so yep. We're giving you the opportunity to lay the first course of bricks in your room.
Right. So we can put the Borough TV bricks down, can we?
The Borough TV bricks are now going to be laid.
Any tips, Paul?
Thank you. Just try and keep them level,
straight. I thought you were going to do a song there for a moment.
Try and keep them level, straight.
Can
what?
Right.
I hope Mrs. Brownlee is watching. She may want a few repairs doing.
Is this right?
I think you're going to have to throw it on a bit thicker than that, Alice.
God. Is that better?
That's better.
Right, stick it on here. On there.
One above the.
Is that it?
Could we just move it along a bit to. There we go.
Can I do another break?
I would like to see a few more done yet, Alistair.
Oh, look at this. Glamour jobs, eh? I'm going to get arrested in the summer, you know, Paul. Is that all right?
We will get arrested in that position, Alistair, I'm sure.
How old are you?
There we go.
Yeah.
There's two.
Two.
I'm definitely glad you're not working for me, Alistair, but there's a fair attempt, and as I say, you've laid the first two bricks of the new media centre here at Hurworth. Thank you.
Thanks very much, Paul. Do you get to wash your hands anywhere?
Oh, yeah.
Hey, come on now, Max, out of 10.
And the pitch will, I'm sure, be in superb condition for the start of the Premier League season in August. Now Borough TV, Bernie's about, this week with fullback Curtis Fleming. It's Borough against Norwich on Sunday. Brian Robson previews. Hold on a second. Brian Robson talks about it. Talks about it. Swallow, Salah.
Understands for Healy.
Okay. It ended goalless, but fantastic and exclusive action from the reserve team fixture, Middlesbrough against. Now, Norwich City have somebody called Dealey. Do you have any for love? Who moved that tree? Girls, come here. Alex, we'll do that again. Can Dealey fell off. Here we go.
Christmas,
we're recording your features on Borough TV. I mean, Viv Anderson interrupts all of the time. Bacon sandwiches arrive from all over the place. Not forgetting, of course, that Brian Robson's phone has his incessant habit of ringing just as soon as we start recording in interviews. But Robbo has promised that for £19.99, he'll pull the sockets, he'll pull the whole thing out the wall, so I cut the fucking line.
Hey, there's another blimmer for the video.
Do you know, I was supposed to do things not.
That was a beauty. Yes. Now, you better get that on there. Tell you what, we made some blimmers here. Come on, don't be shy. We all make blimmers. Come on, let's see you.
Oh, you've ruined it now.
I tell you what, you look very athletic trying to go over that fence.
Oh, and what about the other one? I mean, the bit with Paul Close, they're trying to build rock cliff up.
Dee, come on.
As we know, Scotch, you've gone. You do the.
Can't find this.
We're in the middle of recording. We're in the middle of recording.
Didn't I say I can't find the button?
Come on. Here,
give it a minute. Oh, problem is that you can talk to him. It's a good tune, that.
Hang on. Hello. Bernie?
No, I'm here.
Yeah? Yeah, we're busy doing. What do you mean one or two of the players don't want to do it? Hello? Viv? Yeah. Yeah, I know. Well, we're going to feature you, Viv, in a moment. But you kept interrupting, didn't you? All right, Viv, cheers. Viv Anderson, interrupting things as always.
Phone, lad.
Bernie's phone goes back to him. Viv Anderson interrupts, and Robbo tries to keep his composure. All sorts of things go wrong on Borough TV.
Hello?
Brian, it's obviously been an incredible season. Are you able to draw a little bit of a breath now and take it all in?
Yeah, you can relax. But
can he relax as well?
Yeah, you just, look, he just walks in the middle of anything.
Oh,
for me and
shut
I,
up,
just,
get a piece, man.
I think it's on there.
Should we try again?
I think we should. Was Brian Robson part of it, part of your decision?
Well, obviously, it's a part, isn't it? It's not just Brian Robson, it's just how ambitious the club is. Whoever was manager, if the club's ambitious and wanting to spend money and wanting to bring in top players and...
Tell the truth, guys!
I only come because of Viv, to be fair. I mean,
no. Training every day and the way we then play in the games, I think, you know, it's very pleasing.
Did you feel him?
Mark Swanson.
Mark Swanson. Yeah, that's right.
Hi, Mark. Hello, where are you?
This time we've experienced that. We've been to the finals. We've experienced defeat, and it's not very nice, the defeat side of it. So if you want to really enjoy it, no, I don't want it. I don't want it. See, Anderson. That's why Anderson is getting really fat now, and he can't play anymore because of the bacon sandwiches that he has. And we tell our players they're not allowed to eat anything like that.
It's amazing how we ever get any features recorded on Borough TV. If Anderson interrupts constantly, bacon sandwiches arrive from all over the place.
You know, we're talking about food, bacon sandwiches, burgers. You know, we're talking about food. Carry on.
Cheers, Slav. Bernie Slavin interrupts me. And, of course, Sir Brian Robson's phone rings all of the time. But Robbo has promised that for any features we do in 1999, he'll make sure his phone switched off first. Now, Slav, 1998 has had referees in the news as normal. Who was the worst?
Well, it's not even open to debate who was the worst. It was Paul Alcock, and we were on his trail. There's been a lot of talk over the weekend about the controversial decisions of referee Paul Alcock at Southampton. We've tried to get him by fax, we've tried to get him by phone, all's failed. But we've travelled down to his home, and we're outside at this minute in time. I'm going to get in and see if I can have a word with him. Mr. Alcock, you there? Mr. Alcock? Yeah, it's Bernie Slavin, Borough TV. Yeah. Well, no joy, but I tell you what, we're not going to go anywhere. We're going to sit in the car, we're going to wait for him. That's what we're going to do. Like reptiles of today, they laid their eggs on land and had waterproof skins. As they no longer needed to lay eggs in water, these animals could leave the swamps and enjoy the freedom of living on dry land. Boy, I'll sleep better tonight for knowing that. Excuse me, sir. Have a word. Come on, just a few months. Hey, come on, sir. We've travelled a long way. Come on. Hey, just a few months. Hey, look, just a bit of Saturday. A few months. Come on. Hey, we've travelled 4 hours, sir. Come on. Hey. Hey, let's get them. We're not giving up. We've travelled a long way. Come on. Here he is, yeah. That's him, is that him? I'm sure that is him. Mike's at it red as well. That is him, he's got his Tesco bag. How's it going here? How's it going? He's never going in there. He's getting in the petitions, long overdue. Oh, God! Here! Give us a few words, lad. Come here, wait a minute. Wait, just a few months.
No.
2 minutes. Hey, 2 minutes. Alcock. Hey. I'll be waiting you.
I wonder what it could be. 7:10, I'm going in there.
Excuse me. Sorry about the problems earlier on. Where is he?
He's gone.
Do you know who that guy was?
No.
He was a referee from Saturday. He had an absolute nightmare.
Oh, right.
He took his time in getting a pair of glasses.
He's gone out at the back, and I can't tell you anything about it because it's private.
Exactly, man, there.
That's where he's gone. He's refereeing there.
Right. Are you sure this is it?
I'm positive. That's where he said.
Thanks very much.
Okay.
I've got him. Well, we've arrived at the school, and as far as I know, he's been through the main doors. So we better go and get him. Let's go. Come on.
Hang on, hang on. Yeah. Go on, Adam.
Can't believe it, we've finally caught with the dodgy referee Alcock. Let's get him, come on, let's go. We'll give him a bit of abuse for the sidelines, come on. Come on, Alcock! You're having a nightmare, lad! Alcock! He's having another nightmare. Foul referee! Oh, you got that one right, that's a change! Oh, cop! Hey, can I have a few words? Oh, cop! Can I have a few words with you? That's a foul, man! Hey, you never seen that Saturday! Tell you what, I'm going on. Fed enough, let's go. Alcock! What a lot of you. Saturday, you had an absolute nightmare. Give us a reason. No. Are you anti Borough or what?
No. Just
you sent off Mustle, you sent off Stamp.
Just name
you thought you were a bit of Hitler. No, I'm going to date you. No. You're getting that boy and that. See you later, pal. We've got him. I enjoyed doing that sketch. Played the part well. I think he was actually a better referee than Paul.
I just think it was a tremendous amount of fun. What we've got to say is that people from NTL helped us all around here, the sales have, including Derek, who took the part of the referee.
Just a bit of fun.
And the kids from St David's School in the room as well. So it was really a bit of fun. And we've sent Paul Alcock a copy of the video anyway.
I'm sure I'll enjoy it.
Now, the PR department is spread out in terms of numbers. And let's think about this.
Big Louis.
Well, wait a minute. When you were a footballer, right, how many people used to help you behind the scenes?
No one.
Nobody.
Nobody.
You had to sign your own autographs.
Yeah, you're right,
But now let's think about it. We've got Louise.
Yes.
Who helps out at Rockcliffe, where they're helping all the players' interviews. Cheers for that, Lou. We've got Di with Rory the Lion, who sets up all the interviews with Rory and helps the kids, all that type of thing. We've got Chris Kershaw of the Publications Department, who forgets that you actually play for the Republic of Ireland.
Don't wind me up. Carry on.
And we've got Dave Allen, who does regular news flashes with a variety and degree of professionalism.
He did play the part in those two magnificent wins, and there are already fans afoot.
The fans are afoot.
Applications are still coming in, trickling in on a day-to-day basis from Red Book holders, right up and past deadline. I can't remember what else I was going to say, but there's loads more. Contact the ticket office on 8-7-7-4-5. That's 8-7-7-4-5. If you did apply for the by the March 10th deadline for the tickets for Wembley, please do give us a ring in the ticket office and we'll try and sort that out very quickly. Of course, it was registered post for the cup final tickets, all the tickets were delivered by the registered post, so your tickets may have actually been delivered before now, but there may have been an envelope left for you at your now one of the most popular.
We've got a lot of outtakes for this.
It's Friday night's Borough programme. Riverside Red is one not to be missed for all you Borough fans out there, because in it, Steve Gibson, the Borough chairman, talks about his future aspirations for the football club and about how the club is progressing on and off the pitch here at the Cellnet Riverside Stadium. It's the second in a two-part interview with the Borough chairman, and that's in this Friday night's Borough programme, just £2, on sale in and around the stadium here at the Riverside. And there's also interviews with Craig Hignett, Steve Vickers and somebody else whose name I can't remember.
One minute.
Now, despite the efforts of these two gentlemen beside me, dreams of cup glory are over for another year. But of course, it's back now to the important league action, starting with Bury a week on Saturday, and it's a cup final every match from now on in. And Merce and Nige, of course, will not be our start again.
Now, a reminder to Borough fans, the British summertime starts this weekend and the clocks go forward 1 hour this Sunday morning. And that means if you don't put your clocks forward, you could risk missing this kick-off for the big cup final. So that means, remember, 2 o'clock becomes... Hopefully this forthcoming week there'll be need for the pledge to be out here at the Selnet Riverside Stadium, because fingers crossed Borough are going to be returning to Teesside with the Coca-Cola Cup final. With the Coca-Cola Cup final. No, they bloody won't.
I still can't get out of this video. Is that you?
Please don't, Maud.
Is that really you?
Yes, it is. Look, it's going to go back to the printers. That thing isn't even going to see the light of day. Dave Arnold, Club's PR department, everybody else who helps us out there, that was only a little bit of fun, and don't give up the day job. Now, on the set on Totally Red on Borough TV, we do have problems from time to time because these things fall down all over the place.
Any problems.
And, living legend, whenever we bring out this each week, which is all to do with entries for competitions, you can't even get the people's names right whenever you read them out.
Well, I've had a few problems.
I think Bernie Slaven should take a course in English whilst we enjoy again Trouble on the Set.
Yeah. Let's see, Donna Mullins from Middlesbrough. Well done, Donna.
A bit of artwork right. as well, I think, on that. Well done to Donna.
Kebab.
Right.
This week in Fan of the Week, it's a man who ate all the pies, Simon Murphy. No, don't show that. I've got no. No, no, no. You got to be kidding. Go on, right.
I don't know about you, but I really enjoyed watching that action again. Middlesbrough against Swindon, Borough back at the top of the table, and exclusive to Borough TV, of course, Hamilton Rickard. I'm not sure whether I can shout as loud as that Colombian commentator, but I'll certainly there's that bloody truck going up again. John Hickton.
No. He's doing that. He done that.
I didn't do anything.
Yeah, he's done that with his pen.
Get on with it.
I thought you were blowing that flute. Gaza. Yeah, go on then.
John Hickton.
You're still... He's still laughing. He's like a Cheshire cat.
Okay.
Right, go on then. Hold on, right. Go on. Look. Hold on. Right. Right, go on then.
Yeah. John Hickton.
What about... Sorry, Alec. Hold on, wait, he stops laughing.
Have to control yourself.
Yeah, control yourself,
man.
Yeah, all right.
Burn it.
Dear God, is it mice again?
Go.
John Hickton.
Yeah, true Borough legend. It was a long trip down, but well worth it.
Yeah. Well, now on Borough TV, we look ahead to what should be a crucial time of the season. It's the Easter programme. On Saturday, Middlesbrough entertain Bury at the Super Selnet Riverside Stadium with a 3 p.m. kickoff. And then on Easter Monday, to travel down south to Elm Park. That's Reading against Middlesbrough. For those Borough fans wanting to travel, remember that game also kicks off at 3 p.m. Two vital fixtures. Bernie, how do you see them? I've lost my word at the end.
It's all right.
Well, we have graphics on that.
What do you mean trouble on the set?
Oh, come on now.
Tell you, it's some hat, this, isn't it?
Listen, this is supposed to be a serious video. Give me your hat. Oh. Right.
It's a goal.
Stop it off. We're going to move on now, right? And I want to ask you a question. And the question is going to be simply this. The worst, the most grumpiest manager at the end of the game. Naturally, Middlesbrough have had a tremendous year, 1998. They've battered loads of teams. Some managers have been really grumpy at the aftermatch press
conference. There's only one comes
But who gets the grumpiest of the grump?
Yeah, I'm afraid he's Scottish, and it's Gordon Strachan.
Yeah, obviously, thank you. It's not one idea. Long way to get here. Yeah. Yes. All right. You talk to me because you always do.
What did you make of the performance?
Better team than the day one. All right. Anything else? Quite simple, that, really, isn't it?
In what areas do you think they're better going?
On the big green bit out there, called the pitch.
Any positives to take
there,
Dan? Any positives to take there?
Get away early tonight, I suppose. Not much to talk about, really, so.
Sorry, I couldn't hear you.
We can get away home early. There's a boy in the background talking. You shut up at the back, you might hear me. Sorry about that.
Okay. I can now hear.
Thank you, Ollie. Talk.
Seems to have lost the spark that you showed against Everton last week, Gordon.
Didn't play as well as we did against Everton, Blackburn, and Arsenal.
Any reasons why you think that is, Gordon?
Yeah, as a manager, you've got the weekend to think about, haven't you? You maybe come away with some answers.
At the moment, I have no answers to how Middlesbrough are a better team than us. Brian might give you an answer to that, but at the moment, I can't give an answer.
Have any complaints about the referee, Gordon?
No, have you?
Did you think Ricard had used his hand to control the ball for the second goal?
Yes, I did.
I think it's a case of perhaps defences getting used to the Huckabee-Whelan partnership.
I don't know. I can't. I'm giving you as many honest questions as I can. I can sit here and pontificate, but I'm not real. I'm giving you the honest answers and as much as I can. If I've not got an answer to it, I can't give you. I'm not trying to be difficult, but you ask me a question, I don't have a real answer to it.
What particular disappointed you think, Gordon? Was it the application, was it?
That Middlesbrough were a better team than us. It should be me talking to myself.
Gordon, why did you take Darren Huckabee off?
Wasn't playing as well as he can do.
After watching that, are there particular aspects of that you'd be working at during the week?
A lot of things to be working about. As a coach, it's filled my week. Already? You know, there's got to be a lot already for now. Yeah, we'll be thinking over the weekend, and there'll be plenty to work with over the next couple of days. And I've always said I like coaching. There's my opportunity to get my teeth into it for the next 7 days. Thanks very much. Thank you. Thank you, the mumbler.
The one thing I want to know, was you the mumbler at the back there? Because Gordon Stratton got very upset about
it. Wasn't that. Me. I think it was your mate, Gordon Cox. He's a bit of a mumbler, isn't he?
Ah, Cox is a bit of a mumbler. Right, the summer, we should have had a break. Do you remember? We were all going to be set to lay around, do absolutely nothing for a few months, watch a little bit of football at the World Cup. Then you had that bright idea, do you remember? Let's keep Borough TV going during the summer.
That's right, it was a good idea.
Let's
that.
All go and do exactly the same as the Brazilian
idea.
Football team. Let's all go and try and juggle a football around an airport.
You'd a nightmare.
But unfortunately, Bernie hates airports, so we had to go to Middlesbrough bus station. Well, that looked absolutely smooth, nearly as good as the Brazilian footballers themselves. But we did have one or two problems in shooting it.
Right, stand up, all four. Three of them walk off to me. Half jogging. That's it, lads.
Half jogging. Whoa!
Right,
whoa.
Lads, lad.
Okay, let's try it.
Right.
Well.
Oh, was a good shot!
Right, S1.
Okay.
Right.
Hang on.
Hold on.
Wait for the bus to pass. All right, we're cool. Right, come on.
Right, we're on.
Okay.
Jesus. I'll tell you something, Slav. I reckon one or two people have still got a very sore head after the way you threw that football. You're supposed to be a professional footballer. You couldn't hit anybody in the back of the head. Do you remember that?
Yeah, I do. Absolutely. I enjoyed it.
Yeah, accuracy in throwing was never your strong point, Slaven. No. Right, let's think a little bit now about the things, the traditions which are associated with cup finals. Whether it's a World Cup final, Republic of Ireland. Did you record anything on the song?
I was meant to record on a song, but I missed it through. We had a midweek game.
Okay, and
I was involved in a song.
One moment. What was the Republic of Ireland song?
Can't remember, to be honest. Something to do with Jack.
All right, then. Jack
the song was all about Jack. Song was about Jack.
But what was the Middlesbrough song for the Zenith
Data
Systems Cup
final?
Great song.
I think it was one of the best sellers. It was called We Are Men of Iron. That was a great song.
Okay, come on, Bernie. Sing it.
Can't remember how it goes.
We are men of
that
iron.
Is the
remember it?
That is the
we
one,
are
yeah.
men
I'll play the drums
Steve.
And carry on. You did a good job.
I'm not sure what our singing is like. But some of the current Middlesbrough footballers, or should we say the players that were going to Wembley for the Coca-Cola League Cup final, certainly struggled in the vocal refrain.
squad. Connections for the line. It's another call saving. Another day. Reaching destinations that make communications. Let's save time. Hold the line.
It's another call saving, another day, reaching destination to make communications that save time. Hold the line.
Take six. Another day.
I've missed the start of it, because you were standing in the way when he was singing.
Communications that save time, hold the line.
Top of the pops, here we come.
The quality of the singing there.
Dreadful.
Yeah, I'm not sure that was the real reason why Nigel Pearson decided to retire and Paul Merson moved on to pastures new. They certainly wouldn't make it in the Eurovision Song Contest, or perhaps they would with the Norwegian entry. Right, Bernie, final moments there or thereabouts of this video. Hope everybody's enjoyed it, but there's one decision still to be made.
What's that?
The cover. Are we going to go with that or not?
Definitely not. Yeah. I'll thank the kids that.
Well, there's one thing certain. Irrespective of which cover we decide to use eventually in this video, that in 12 months' time, there'll still be as much fun as ever around Borough TV. I certainly hope they've enjoyed Outtakes and Oddballs. So for myself, Alistair Brownie, for at least another 12 months in terms of the video, and the Borough legend, Bernie Seven.
See ya.
Can we just stop you ladies free our shopping for one moment?
Right.
Borough TV.
Right.
We've been speaking to fellas so far,
oh,
it's about
right.
time you girls had a
yes,
go, right?
I think so, no?
I would think so. How high do you think the Borough are going to finish this season? Now, come on, don't turn away like that. It's just if I'm going to give you a free packet of washing up powder.
Oh, I don't know. They're not consistent, that's the trouble with them. They go in, do the first half brilliantly, score the goals, great. Come back in the second half and they just go to pot. They do, I think they do, just go to pot.
So what would you do if you were in the dressing room to give him a half-time team talk, then?
I'd give him a good kick up the arse.
I think that would be a big miss, but you've still got Mess, and Mess will probably play further forward than he would like. But Mess is a very, very, very good player. I mean, he could be...
Is that you there, Stammy? So, Stammy! Why don't we kiss him? Stammy, thanks for joining us. Let's hope you have a good season, injury-free season, and how about a goal?
Yeah, I'm due a goal, so hopefully injury-free season and a first team place.
See ya. Yeah, yeah, fine. Great.
Still
well
about
done.
8 ton of shit back.
Do it, sure. I think you're right off.
Stephen Wilson of Billingham, he said he watched in amazement Mark Schwartz's display against Port Vale. He said, you obviously, Robbo, have been involved with the likes of Peter Schmeichel. How good, should we say again?
I'll give him a ring, Karen. I'll only be a couple of more minutes. Yeah. Okay, thanks.
Right.
Are you in the middle of an interview?
That's right.
Well, Bernie, did you enjoy your meal? I enjoyed the meal, but I think we'll have to stop inviting people for meals.
Have you had the money?
Have a bit of money.
Now, look, hard work is needed. Only 6,000 more dishes to go before Butter TV goes out on Thursday night. I hope it was worth it.
You still in there?
Commemorate the Borough's first visit to Wembley Zenith Cup final, yeah. March 25th, 1990.
And the Borough were playing, and you were playing.
And
so
we were beaten 1-0 by Chelsea yet again.
Well done, Slav, there's a surprise. Pack mailbag. OK, so we'll draw first of all, I think, for the shirt signed by Robbo and Viv.
I was going to fix it there.
You wouldn't do it.
Let's see.
There's children watching this.
Let me see. Daniel Thorpe from Hemlington.
That isn't an entry, that's an essay.
Okay, then.
Just sorry. Behind the settee. Right, I'll find that later, Daniel, I promise. And now for the memento of Borough's trip to Wembley, the first final.
I'm sorry, I've not won. Dear God.
Look at that. Very impressive building over there.
Yeah, we're just looking at that. It's almost as big as your house, Alistair.
That is my house.
Yeah, it's coming on. This time, at the end of last season,
yeah.
There was nothing there, but they've certainly threw it up, and it's looking good.
Let's take a full look behind the scenes now on Totally Reds. Developments both here and also at the Super Sellout Riverside Stadium in the company of Taylor Woodrow. I thought he was going to say, I thank you over there. Totally Red on Borough TV is a football programme. So what on earth are we doing here at the Circus of Horrors? I'm not sure. Bernie, what tell us about
it? I brought you here for a job.
What am I going to do? Pull the tendo?
There's several things you could do with a phrase like that. No, kidding aside, I've heard you ranting and raving about Janino.
What do you know about that? Greatest football?
Over the last couple
skills.
Of years. Yeah, he's got great balancing skills, but I've got a guy here today, Pitcho. I've brought you here to really appreciate skill. This is what you call balancing skill.
Well, where is he then?
So he's right here. He's right here. Okay.
Tell me something, OK, I mean, he's made a career in the Circus of Horrors. Why wouldn't he make a career in football?
Be no good at corner kicks.
I love you, Tommy. I could ask me the way.
Sing it out.